Shaun, we are at the start of 2024. We've been hearing of some momentum at the end of last year in the housing market. But maybe let's just talk about Canada's condo market, the rental market. What did Q4 2023 look like?
Yeah, in the rental market within the GTA, we saw market conditions transition towards somewhat of a more moderate environment. We began the year with annual rent growth rising at a double-digit pace. As we looked at the fourth quarter numbers, we saw that condominium rents in the GTA were up by about 4.5% on a year-over-year basis. So a much slower rate of rent growth than what the market has been used to over the last couple of years. And that's really due to a few factors. One, I think it's a response to a big surge in rents that happened between the first quarter and the third quarter that really eroded rental affordability. It brought average rents in the GTA up to about $3,000 a month. At the same time, we had a surge in international students arriving into the region. And then from there, as the market kind of transitioned towards its slower seasonal period during the fourth quarter, we saw rents dip quarter over quarter, and then we saw the annual rate of growth transition towards its more historical average of around 4.5%.
Tell us what you've been seeing in the condo market when it comes to sales, when it comes to construction starts. What does that picture look like?
So condo sales in the GTA for new construction, pre-construction units in 2023 fell 41% from 2022. We had less than 13,000 sales last year. It was the lowest total since 2008 at the onset of the global financial crisis. And it's well below the long-term trend level of about 25,000 sales a year. So it was a substantial slowdown. Pre-construction buyers were mainly on the sidelines. As a result, we saw higher levels of unsold inventory, mainly within pre-construction projects. And as that's happened, construction starts have slowed down considerably. We actually saw in the second half of last year a 72% year-over-year plunge in construction starts for condos. And we're expecting that slowdown is going to continue into 2024, given the fact that new construction condo sales have been so slow over the last couple of years. And in order for developers to start construction on new projects, they need to sell at least 70 to 80% of those units. And that's just not happening right now. So construction activity is going to fall. At the same time, we're actually going to see higher levels of completions because of all the units that are under construction right now. And we're actually projecting that by the end of 2024, we're going to have 20,000 fewer units under construction compared to the peak in the end of 2022. So we're in for a pretty significant slowdown in condo construction over the next year.
And what are you attributing that slowdown to? I mean, we're obviously operating in this, high inflationary environment, higher interest rate environment. What does the labor picture look like on the construction side? And I'm also going to throw in, what do the regulatory obstacles look like, if you could weave all of that in?
Yeah, certainly in terms of pre-construction sales, the slowdown is mainly attributed to interest rates at a 22-year high. Condo affordability has eroded significantly. So, you know, even with some deflation in condo prices over the last couple of years, the average mortgage payment associated with buying the average price unit is up 20%. So it has seen a big deterioration in affordability. At the same time, developers are dealing with still near record high construction costs, soaring development charges, high taxation, and it doesn't give them a lot of room to lower new condo prices to help to spur more demand and more sales and by extension construction activity. So we're stuck in this difficult situation where demand has slowed down because of high interest rates. Developers are kind of stuck because they're dealing with record high costs. And as you mentioned, there's only a kind of a fixed amount of labor supply right now. And it's taking longer and longer for projects to move through the system. And it's really starting to choke supply. And you know, we're going to see that come to fruition in the next few years, given that there is a lag between pre-construction sales, construction starts, and then final completions. In a few years from now, we're going to be dealing with a very significant slowdown in new deliveries. At the same time, obviously, this is going to happen as the government continues to target record levels of new immigration. So the mismatch between demand and supply fundamentally in the market is unfortunately only going to get worse.
Let's talk about that that lag effect from a purchase to completion. I know that you had mentioned a few years and how that might affect supply. What is the expectation then for this year and as you see that horizon?
Yeah, I think you know, the supply that's going to be entering the market over the next couple of years is going to look much different than the quantities of supply that are going to be entering the market in 4 to 5 years' time. We had just over 21,000 condo completions in 2023. It was one of the highest levels that we've ever seen. That was also one of the reasons why we started to see rent growth slow down. We just saw a lot of condos listed for rent. We also saw a multi-decade high for purpose-built rental completions last year. So there was a pretty good increase in supply in 2023. Obviously, demand outpaced that supply, which is why you saw rents continue to increase. But as we move through 2024, I think, you know, a lot of the factors that were impacting rents are still going to be there, but probably to a more muted degree. You know, we're probably going to see home sales begin to increase. They were at 20-year lows in the GTA last year, with expected at least slight reductions in interest rates. We should see affordability improve at least somewhat, and that will move some first-time buyers into the marketplace and alleviate some of the pressures on the rental market. As well, we'll probably see a higher level of unemployment, so some slack opening up in the labor market, and that should, at least to some degree, lessen the amount of rental demand going into the market. And at the same time, we'll see, as I mentioned, at least a temporary increase in supply coming from condo completions that are expected to rise to at least 25,000 units this year. And as well, we'll still continue to see a decent amount of purpose-built rental completions. That supply decrease is going to be lagged by a few years. And in that regard, we'll see rents, I think, continue to trend pretty close to the rate of growth that we saw in the fourth quarter of last year. So kind of in the 4 to 5% range. Condo prices, I think, will start to pick up just with the reduction in interest rates. You'll see at least some improvement in condo sales and at least an uptick in condo prices. But I'm not expecting a huge turnaround in the market for condo sales in 2024. I think there's still going to be a lot of uncertainty around interest rates and obviously some uncertainty and hesitation regarding the economic outlook.
Lastly, the federal government has yet to announce when they will table the spring budget. Is there any expectation you'll see anything in there for when it comes, I guess, to you talked a little bit about affordability, but especially as it pertains to this segment, the rental and condo market?
Yeah, I hope so. I think the move to remove GST, HST from new rental construction has certainly been a positive first step. And in fact, one of the things that we saw in the fourth quarter was an improvement in rental construction starts. We actually saw that rental construction in the fourth quarter moved above 2,000 units. It was a 10 quarter high, actually. And that brought the total number of rental construction starts for the GTA in 2023 up above 5,000 units. And it was the third highest level that we've seen in the past 10 years. And really a dramatic turnaround from the first half of the year when we were seeing very little new rental construction happening. So I think if we see more policy encouragement to reduce development charges, you know, there could be other things like lower taxes, initiatives to help improve labor supply, invest in innovation to make apartment construction more efficient. And I think, you know, at the municipal level, I think there's a real need to reduce application and approval timelines. So I hope we see that. At the federal level, I think, you know, continuing to offer low-cost loans for purposeful rental construction, it's been a huge contributor to the growth in rental construction that we have seen to date. So making sure that remains in place, I think, is going to be incredibly important.
Thank you.